Okay, so today in this class we are going to start with something called alternating series. So you see, till now हमने जो किया है NH term test, GP, HP, sorry, telescopic series वाला जो हमने किया था, these concepts, and then series AN is convergent if and only if sequence of partial sums is convergent. So these concepts are applicable on general series. मतलब कोई restriction नहीं थी. उसके बाद जो हमने किया Cauchy integral test, then we did LCT, DCT, ratio, root. So on these tests, the terms should be positive. AN should be greater than equal to zero. Do you remember? Fine. So now you see, mostly we are using these tests for checking the convergence and divergence of a series. And this here is a big restriction that the terms should be positive. So right now, where we are going is we are trying to see that how we can handle with the series where we don't have this condition of all the terms positive, right? So in that direction, so we are moving in a direction. We are moving in a direction where terms may be negative, right? So obviously, when we move from one thing to other thing, so we try simpler things first, right? So in the same way, first of all, we'll be looking at alternating series, right? So let us see what is an alternating series. See, from the name itself, alternating means one is of one kind, then another kind, then the same kind, another kind, and so on. So if you have a series like this, 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 7 minus 1 by 8 and so on. So what is happening here? One term is positive, then third term is positive, fifth is positive, seventh is positive, and second is negative, fourth is negative, and so on. So what is there? Positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. So alternatingly, you have positive, negative terms. So such a series is called an alternating series. Okay, so let me write down a series in which the terms are alternatively positive and negative. Positive and negative is an alternating series. Is that okay? So you can have many examples. For example, this series here is an alternating. Yes. Then you have minus 2. Your first term can also be negative. Plus 1, minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 8, plus 1 by 16, and so on. So this is another series which is an alternating series. You can have 1, minus 2, plus 4, plus 3, minus 4, plus 5, minus 6, plus 7, minus 8, and so on. This is also alternating. Is that okay? So alternating has a very simple definition that the signs of the terms are alternatively positive and negative. That's it. One term is positive, another is negative, then the next is positive, and the next is negative, and so on. And it is not required that the first term should be positive. So your first term can be positive or negative. You can see from here. Okay, so I am assuming that this definition of alternating series is clear to everybody. Right?
Now, it can be AP, GP, or HP.
सॉरी बेटा
मैम, इसमें मतलब एपी जीपी एचपी कोई सी भी हो सकती है टर्म्स, मतलब वो पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव होनी चाहिए फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड.
यू कैन हैव लाइक दिस, लेट मी राइट डाउन दिस. यू कैन हैव वन, कुछ भी, देयर इज नो रिलेशन. सपोज यू हैव अ सीरीज लाइक दिस, लेट मी राइट डाउन. you have a series like this, minus 1 raised to power n plus 1, n upon n square plus log n, right? Okay, now here n is from 1 to infinity. So everything here is positive. So this here tells you that first term will be positive, second term will be negative, third term will be positive, right? So here, what is this? This is 1 upon 1 square plus log 1. Second is negative sign, 2 upon 2 square plus log 2. Third is positive sign, that is 3 upon 3 square plus log 3. Next is negative, 4 upon 4 square plus log 4, and so on. So there is nothing, this is not HPGP, there is no such restriction. The only thing is, terms should be positive, negative. So this is the general form that your series should look like, minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 or n, whatever you want. So by convention, we write like this, n from 1 to infinity, where un is positive. So this is how you can write an alternating series. This is how you can write an alternating series. Is that clear? So here you see,
un is any general.
Yeah, it is anything. No restriction. Alternating has only one restriction, that the term should be positive, negative. अब यहाँ पे if this is positive, अगर नहीं, if this is not positive, then there is a chance that this negative will become positive. That is why we are putting this condition that un should be positive. If un is positive, then this here ensures that terms are alternating. If one term is negative, the next for sure is positive, and the next for sure is negative, and so on. Is that
ma'am? But if un is negative, then also this can happen.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. One, like, it should not happen that every time it is positive, negative. No. Either this or this. Okay? There should be one condition that if all the UNs are positive or all the UNs are negative. If all the UNs are negative, then you can include the negative sign here. So that is why we generally put UN greater than or equal to zero. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that thing clear? So, alternating series, anybody else is having doubt in alternating series? What is the definition? Okay, so let us go ahead. I have written some series here, jo main examples thi. I'll write down those series again. So, let me look at this series, which we just wrote. Minus 2 plus 1, minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 8, plus 1 by 16, minus 1 by 32, and so on. This is an alternating series. Can you comment anything about the convergence of this series? Anybody? Can you comment?
Ma'am, convergent.
Convergent.
It is
modal less than.
With
as common ratio is less than 1.
Equal to minus half. R mod half, which is less than 1. Therefore, convergent. Fine. Now, let us look at another example. 1 minus 2 plus 3 minus 4 plus 5 minus 6 plus 7 minus 8 plus 9 minus 10 plus 11.
Ma'am, aapki awaaz clear nahi aa rahi hai.
Oh, good. Now you tell me. Is it audible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me if it is not clear. Okay. So there is an internet problem. I can see that. So we can wait. Okay. So now you look at this series. This was complete. You get it? That this is a convergent series because this is a geometric progression with common ratio minus half. So mod r is half, which is less than 1. So this is convergent. Okay. Now if you look at the second series, can you tell me, is it convergent or divergent?
Divergent.
Infinity.
Yeah, because if you look at this term test, limit n going to infinity, an is not zero, right? It is actually going to infinity. Therefore, nth term test gives you divergent. Fine? So it means that on alternating series, you can apply your previous tests sometimes. But obviously, I told you that you can apply only these tests on the general series. These tests will not be applied because these are applied only when you have a positive term series. Is that clear to everybody?
Ma'am, can you explain second question again?
This one, second? Yeah. Here, what is this here? You have summation n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 n. This is your series, right? What is the limit of this term as n goes to infinity? That is either infinity or minus infinity. So, this is non-zero. So, nth term test that says that this is a divergent series. Is that okay? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. Now, I will, here you could find out by applying the previous test. If you look at this series which I gave you, minus 1, minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 4, plus 1 by 5, minus 1 by 6, plus 1 by 7, minus 1 by 8, and so on. Right. Now, you try applying your test here. This is called actually alternating harmonic series. Alternating harmonic series. Just the name. Okay. Can you apply nth term test? What is this series? Minus 1 raised to power n plus 1, 1 by n. N from 1 to infinity. Nth term test valid here or not?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Zero.
Zero. Anything else? Is it GP? No. Is it
No, ma'am.
No.
No, ma'am.
And SN also, you will. So, this is a series where your old things will not work. Fine. And other than these tests, you cannot apply LCT, DCT, Cauchy integral, or the ratio and root because this is not a positive term series. So, we are going to study. Yes.
So, ma'am, this means that all the old tests may or may not give the right answer in this case.
Not the right answer. There is either or the right answer. No? It may not happen ki wrong answer aayega kahin se. Koi bhi test aapko, no test will tell you the wrong answer. No? Either it is valid because I cannot apply ratio test here. Why? Because this is not a positive term series. It is not that ratio test will give me a wrong answer.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, so either a test will be applicable or it will be not applicable. That's it. But it is not that ratio test will give you the right answer and root test will give you the wrong answer. No. Okay? Fine. So let us study one test which is called Leibniz test. Leibniz, this is the name of the mathematician, Leibniz test, or this is also called alternating series test. Okay, AST we call it, alternating series test. So what is this test? This test says that suppose you have a series summation n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 un with un greater than equal to 0. So this just makes it a alternating series. You are putting this restriction that un is greater than equal to 0 means you are making sure that this series here is alternating. Right? Second condition is that un is decreasing. It means that the next term, the second term is smaller than the first term. Third term is smaller than the second term. So you are saying here that U1 is greater than or equal to U2 is greater than or equal to U3 is greater than or equal to U4 and so on. Right? And the third condition you are saying is limit N going to infinity, UN is 0. Right? So this test says that if all these three conditions are satisfied, then you will say that the series n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 un is convergent. Okay. If any one or more conditions are not satisfied, then you cannot say anything. You cannot say anything. You will not say that this is divergent. Again, I am not going to prove this test, but
ma'am,
सॉरी बेटा
मैम, अगर दो मतलब वो असलटसा कर गई और एक मतलब नहीं करी तो तब क्या आएगा?
So I'm saying you will not conclude anything. This test will not work. That is what I'm saying. Either one or more conditions are not satisfied. It means that two are satisfied, one is not satisfied. So it means that test is not applicable. That's it.
Okay, ma'am.
So it does not mean that it is divergent or anything else. Is that thing clear? So let me give you an example. So you have three conditions to check. Positivity of UNs, UN should decrease, and limit UN should be zero. Let me give you example. So the example which we're looking at, -1^(n+1)/(1/n). So here you see what is happening. UN here is 1 by n. UN is positive, pehli condition. The second condition, you can clearly see that 1/(n+1) is less than equal to 1 by n because denominator increasing. Here denominator is larger as compared to this. So this term is smaller as compared to this. So this implies UN plus 1 is less than is equal to UN. That is UN is decreasing. Okay. And the third condition, that limit n going to infinity UN, that is limit n going to infinity 1 by n is 0. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So therefore, you get that by Leibniz test, summation n from 1 to infinity -1^(n+1)/(1/n) is convergent. Got it? Everybody got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, beta. So, this screen is hanged. I don't know why. You have to wait. Meanwhile, can you try this thing? N from 1 to infinity -1^(n+1) log n upon n. Can you try this? Let me just again. You have to look at -1^(n+1). Okay, so that something is lost. Okay, let me write down again. So we have here UN is 1 by n. UN greater than equal to 0 in the last question. Okay. Everybody is with me? Anybody having any doubt?
No, ma'am.
-1^(n+1) log n upon n, right? So what is this? Here you have UN is log n upon n. Is it positive?
Yes.
So is it thing?
Yes, ma'am.
How do you know?
Number
by differentiation.
Yeah. So you have log x upon x. You can take f of x, then f dash x squared log x upon x squared. Okay. So 1 - log x is less than 0. If and only if log x is greater than 1, if and only if x is greater than equal to 10. So it is okay. I told you that if the first few terms are not working well, it is okay. So you can say that UN plus 1 is less than equal to UN for n greater than equal to 11. Right? Yeah, this is greater here. Right? Or 10 or 11. After 10 or 11, you have the terms decreasing. So I told you already that whenever you have a result, it is valid for n greater than equal to capital N. Finite number of terms, if they are not working, they are not satisfying your conditions, then it is okay. Then limit n going to infinity, log n by n. Everybody knows this is 0 by L'Hopital rule. Therefore,
yes,
Leibniz test says it is convergent. Is that okay? So this is how you will apply Leibniz test.
Ma'am, second condition mein x greater than 11 ki jagah x greater than 10 nahi hona chahiye.
Yeah, maine yahan strictly liya hai beta. So yeah, you can take 10. Okay. Doesn't matter, right? Because we are just eliminating the first few terms. That will not change the behavior of the series. Fine, beta? Yeah. So this was alternating series test. One more thing, we have started exercise 8.7. So by now, up to 8.6, it is finished. And up to tutorial 2, it is finished. So 8.7 is about this. From today, the lecture is about 8.7 and tutorial 3. So everybody should be on tutorial 3. If not, by this week, your tutorial 2 should be completed. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Please show the last question.
Last question, beta?
Yes, ma'am. Please show.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you can just note it. Then we will go to the next part.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, beta?
Ma'am, there was a doubt in the alternating harmonic series. हमने अकॉर्डिंग टू लेबनीज टेस्ट हमने इसको कन्वर्जेंट प्रूव किया लेकिन मेरे को डाइवर्जेंट लग रहा है ये
क्यों लग रहा है व्हाई
एक सेकंड आप वहां आपने जहां लिखा था ना पूरा सीरीज ओपन करके उधर से स्क्रॉल करेंगे
दिस राइट हियर 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 7 minus व्हाई दिस लुक्स डाइवर्जेंट
मैम अगर आप फर्स्ट टू टर्म्स को ऐड करें तब आपका हाफ आ जाएगा आंसर
यस
नेक्स्ट टू टर्म्स को ऐड करेंगे तो 1 by 6 आ जाएगा
यस
ऐसे ऐसे करते जाएंगे तो आपको 1 by 3 n के फॉर्म में आ जाएंगे टर्म्स शायद
सो व्हाट इज दिस दिस इज 30 राइट दिस इज 1 by 56 द नेक्स्ट विल बी 1 by 9 1 by 10 1 by 90 एंड सो ऑन सो हियर यू कैन नॉट सी एनीथिंग बेटा
अच्छा हां पैटर्न नहीं आ रहा
ओके 1 by n स्क्वायर आल्सो दैट वाज ऑल्सो कन्वर्जेंट
ओके गॉट इट
So you cannot see anything by just looking at it. Okay. So obviously your point is valid that we are adding this small things, but we are adding. Then how we can expect that we will get a finite thing? So I told you already that you can still get a finite thing even if you are adding very small thing infinitely many times. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So that is everywhere. We have seen 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8. This is also a convergent series. We know that the sum is A upon 1 minus R. So this sum is 2. So, but we can expect that because we are keeping, we are adding infinitely many times, however small. So we can expect that this is infinity, but it is not infinity. So this is the whole point of this series thing, na?
Got it, beta?
Okay, beta. So next thing is the alternating series estimation theorem. The alternating series estimation theorem. So what is this? So here this theorem tells you that suppose you have this series n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 un. This is your series and un is positive. All the three conditions which we have written above, un plus 1 less than is equal to un. Third one, that limit n going to infinity, un is 0, are satisfied. Then you are saying that n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1, un is convergent. It means that there is a sum for this series. Let us say the sum is l is equal to n from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n plus 1, un. So suppose this is your sum. Fine? Is that okay? This much statement is clear to everybody? Because I don't know the formula that what will be the sum. I don't know. As in GP, only in GP you know the formula. That's it. Nowhere else you have got the formula for the sum. Everywhere DCT, LCT, ratio, root, all these tests just tell you whether the series is convergent or not. That's it. They are not telling you what will be the sum. Is that thing clear to everybody? And yes. Most of the times we are not interested in sum. We are interested in whether we will be having a convergent series or divergent. That's it. So now I don't know the sum here also. So I'm just calling it L. In practice, what people do, they say, okay, so you are sure that the sum is there, that the sum is, this is a convergent series. So for sure it has a finite sum. So I just want to know what is that sum. So what I can do, I can just take, say, first 100 terms. You know? If I take the first 100 terms, because anyway, I know that if an is convergent, then it implies limit an is 0. So I know that these terms keep on decreasing. So I can take first 100 terms. That will give me an approximate sum. And if somebody else wants a better result, he or she can take first 200 terms. He will get a better sum. And if somebody still wants a better sum, he or she can take first 1,000 terms and so on. Do you get it? Okay, so let me write down this thing so that although you don't know what is the sum of the series, of a convergent series. Okay, obviously, divergent series, we will not talk about sums. But you can add, say, first 100 terms. This you can always do in a computer. First 100 terms, you can make a code to add first 100 terms. You will get an approximate value of sum. Okay, say S1. Now you can take first 1,000 terms. You will get a better approximation S2. Then you can take 2,000 or 10,000 terms. You will get a better approximation of your sum. Okay? There will come a stage where if you keep on adding more terms, there will be very less change in the sum because the terms later on will be very small. Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
okay, ma'am. So here also, suppose I am taking first n terms. Here, in this series, this is general. This is, I'm talking about general series. Now, in this series, minus 1 raised to power n plus 1, un plus 1, I am saying that the total sum is L. So this is actual value of the sum. Actual value of the sum. And suppose I take first n terms, capital N terms. So that is, I am adding u1 minus u2 plus u3 minus u4 and so on, minus 1 raised to power n plus 1 un. So these many terms I am adding, sn. Okay? So I know that sn is an approximation to L. It means that it will be close to L. So sn will be an approximation to L. Got it? Now, we would like to know the difference, that is the error or error, because SN minus L minus SN, this is your error. Okay? Generally, people take mod for error because whether it is positive or negative does not matter. So, the estimation theorem tells us that this error in magnitude is less than or equal to un plus 1. So this is the first discarded term, magnitude of the first discarded term, and sine of L minus Sn is same as sine of un plus 1. So this is your first discarded term. So we are not going to prove this theorem again. So you have this result from the estimation theorem. It tells you that how much is the error. Error will be less than is equal to the magnitude of the first discarded term, right? And the sine L minus Sn. You have to make sure you are not writing it as Sn minus L. Then the sign will change. So the sine of L minus Sn will be same as sine of un plus 1. Un plus 1 means, iska sign kya hai? The sign for un plus 1 is minus 1 raised to power n plus 2. Okay? Is that thing okay? Sine of un plus 1. Yes,
can I repeat this discarded one concept?
Yeah, with an example. Okay. Yeah. So you look at this. N from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to power n. Okay, 1 by 2n. Suppose this is my series. N plus 1. Okay. This is my series. And here your un is 1 by 2n. Un is positive. Un plus 1 is less than equal to un. And limit n going to infinity. Un is 0. Therefore, convergent by Leibniz test. Convergent by Leibniz test. Okay. So now, this is convergent by Leibniz test. Suppose you are adding first 7 terms. Let us say you are adding first 7 terms. So you will not actually add it. So you are saying that I am adding first 7 terms means first term is 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 6 minus 1 by 7. Right. So the theorem says that suppose.
Now I guess you missed.
Sorry, beta.
Nothing, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
Sorry, मैंने गलत लिख दिया यहाँ पे. 5, 6, 7 नहीं आएगा. So this is 8, 16, 32. 1 by 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Is that thing okay?
मैं भी कितने भी terms add कर सकते हैं.
You get, if you are adding first 7 terms, I'm saying if you are adding first 7 terms, then exact answer suppose is L, then L minus S7 magnitude will be less than is equal to the first discarded term. First discarded term matlab 1 by 28 you are discarding. So that will be less than is equal to 1 by 128. And sign will be, this sign will be negative. Because 1 by 128 ka sign kya hai? Negative.
मैम ये साइंस तो सर डिफरेंट हो गया ना. 1 कैसे स्टार्ट, n इक्वल्स टू 1 से तो स्टार्ट है.
1 by 2 होगा.
By 2.
Yes ma'am. First term 1 by 2.
Minus 1 by 4.
Sorry.
नहीं minus 1 by 2 नहीं आई. 1 by
2.
Minus 1 by 4.
Is that okay now?
Right.
Is that okay now? I just
yes, ma'am.
Power n
yes.
minus
1. Yes. Yeah? Yes ma'am.
Now, if I add first 8 terms, add first 8 terms. So, kya hoga? Your S8 will be 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 16 minus 1 by 32 plus 1 by 64 minus 1 by 128 plus 1 by 256. This is the discarded term. This is not included in S8. So, this is your first discarded term here. This is your first discarded term in this case. If you are adding the first 8 terms. Meera, please put yourself on mute. So we are saying L minus S8 is less than is equal to 1 by 256. And L minus S8 has positive sign. So what is the idea of this theorem? This theorem is actually to tell you that without doing the actual calculations. Because you see, somebody can say, ki, I need a value of sum which is close to the exact value by say, somebody saying that I can tolerate 1 by 200 error. Suppose somebody is doing an experiment and in that experiment, this much error is allowed. So what actually, if this theorem is not there, so what he will do? First, he will add 7 terms and then he will somehow have to see that how much is the error. And again, that is not possible because L is not known. Are you getting my point? So there is no way that he could judge that how much is the error if this theorem is not there. So what this theorem is saying that without adding, it will just give you an estimation. For example, here he will know that the error will be 1 by 128. And this is more than the error which is allowed in my experiment. So that is why he will not go for sum of 7 terms. Then the theorem will tell him that if you take the first 8 terms, put yourself on mute. then the error is going to be 1 upon 125, 256, which is less than the error allowed in his experiment. So he will take the sum of first eight terms. Do you get it?
L जो है वो पूरी सीरीज का सम है.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, L is your exact sum. You see,
ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
That we are running.
So ma'am, we will add. So ma'am, this means that we will add the terms until we get a number less than the error that we need. So ma'am, does this mean that we'll have to add the terms until we get the sum as error, which is less than?
For example, if error required. Yeah, I will tell you a question. I will give you an example.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Let me give you an example. Minus 1 raised to the power n plus 1, 1 by 2 raised to the power n. Minus 1. Suppose this is the series and I ask you how many terms do I need to add so that error is less than say 1000. Okay? So what you will say? You will say if you are adding, you are adding n terms, then the error is kitna? N plus 1 is term. 1 by 2 raised to power n plus 1 minus 1. I know that this much is the error. I want it to be less than 1 by 1000. So that is what I want. 2 raised to power n should be greater than or equal to 1000. So I want n should be greater than or equal to log 100,000 by log 2. So at least these many terms I need to add. So this theorem gives you an idea that how many terms you need to add if you already know the error.
तो मैम इन क्वेश्चंस हम लोग को एरर दिया रहेगा ना मतलब
यस यस बेटा यस ओके दिस दिस इज फ्रॉम एस्टिमेशन थ्योरम सो समबडी वाज आस्किंग अ डाउट कैन यू गो फॉर दैट बेटा
यस मैम
एल माइनस एस 7 पता ही चलेगा पॉजिटिव है या नेगेटिव
बेटा आई एम नॉट प्रूविंग द थ्योरम एक्चुअली बेटा सो दिस आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट एल माइनस एस 7 साइन विल बी सेम एज दैट ऑफ द एन प्लस 1 टर्म जो भी उसका दैट इज द साइन माइनस वन रेज टू पावर एन प्लस टू इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस सीरीज सो वॉट एवर इज द साइन ऑफ द फर्स्ट डिस्कार्डेड टर्म दैट विल बी द साइन ऑफ एल माइनस एस एन बट जनरली वेन वी टॉक अबाउट एरर साइन इज नॉट दैट मच इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज एरर मीन्स वी आर लुकिंग एट द मैग्नीट्यूड इज दैट ओके बट ऑब्वियसली फॉर योर क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन साइन ऑल्सो यस बेटा
Ma'am, but this test is neither giving us the sum nor it is telling us the series convergence or divergence.
No.
So
why? Why? This is telling you. Why it is not telling you? You see, we are saying that if all the three conditions are satisfied, then the series is convergent. We just checked it, beta. Minus okay. 1 is convergent. 1 by n is convergent.
Ma'am, if we find S8 and put its value in L minus S8 is less than 1 by 256, then can we get the range of L?
Sorry, beta?
Ma'am, if we find S8...
You will get a range of S. Yes, beta. Obviously, this value, I can tell you, this is actually, I have computed it. This is... in this case, though, you can know L also, beta. This is a GP, no?
Yes, ma'am.
That you can anyway get an L. So the GP with this is 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 8. So the sum is 1 upon 1 minus minus half. So the sum is 2 by 3. Okay. So in this case, you can actually get a sum. So you can see 2 by 3 is L. I have computed S8 also. This is actually point. S is 0.6640625. So you can see L minus S8 if I will do this will be equal to 0.002604166. And this number here is 0.0039. So you can see that this number is less than this. But obviously you are right. When we are not able to compute this L, you can compute S8. But so then you will get a range for L. Okay. So based on these things, you can get questions. Okay, mm-hmm. So time is up. Tomorrow, you can please bring your doubts. First 20 minutes, I will cover something which is called absolute and conditional convergence. Absolute and conditional convergence. And then I will take your doubts. Is that okay, Vita?
Ma'am, can you please scroll up for a second?
Yeah, sir. Where is it okay now?
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, just जब इसमें आपको पता चल गया जैसे L माइनस S8 का पॉजिटिव साइन और L की अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू पता चल गई
yes.
तो इस हिसाब से आपने इसको तब बोला कि ये कन्वर्जेंट है
नो no, बेटा कन्वर्जेंट वाली चीज ऊपर हो चुकी है दिस इज जस्ट अनदर दिस इज एन एडिशन टू व्हाट वी वर डूइंग ऑलरेडी है ना सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट टिल नाउ वी आर वही तो मैं बता रही हूं सपोज समबडी But you don't have a formula for sum, right? So how will he know that how many terms I need to add? Okay, so usko for that he needs some tests, some estimations. So we don't have estimation in every series, but we are lucky to have an estimation when your series is an alternating series. That is why I am telling you this test here. Got it, Peter?
Ma'am, please, ye wala question first explain kar denge ma'am.
Estimation kyun hoga? Tomorrow, it's time up.
मैम बस एक मिनट बता दीजिए चीज जो मैम आपने इससे पहले वाला जो क्वेश्चन कराया था उसमें हम लोग को एरर कितना दिया हुआ था मैम
कौन से क्वेश्चन में बेटा
मैम जो माइनस वन टू द पावर एन इनटू वन अपॉन टू टू द पावर एन माइनस वन
नो एरर वाज गिवन बेटा आई थिंक यू आर मिसिंग समथिंग कैन यू जस्ट लुक दिस वीडियो अगेन एंड देन टुमारो यू कैन आस्क योर डाउट्स
ओके मैम
explain tomorrow again okay I will give a summary of this estimation theorem is that okay
yes ma'am
okay ma'am yeah.
okay beta thank you everybody have a nice
thank
day
you, ma'am.
Thank you ma'am
thank you ma'am
thank you ma'am
thank you beta